In this video, I will show you an idea how to make your site more unique by using custom fonts. For that, we will use CSS Web Fonts, a technology that was first invented in the 1990s, but only since CSS3 became widely adopted. Hello and welcome. Thank you for coming and joining me in this video. My name is Artur, and here at my channel, I'm challenging you with various web dev ideas. There is only a bunch of fonts which we can consider web safe. By web safe, I mean fonts that you can be moderately confident your users will have. This includes Arial and Times New Roman on Windows or Helvetica on Mac. But what about the other fancy fonts that you can find on the internet and freely use in your designs? For that, we can use web fonts. The fun fact is that this technology has existed for over 20 years. It was proposed for CSS 2.1, but was dropped before the standard was finalized. Surprisingly, Internet Explorer implemented it in 1999, but it was the only browser that had it, and the implementation was limited to EOT fonts only. Once the web fonts were included in the CSS 3, they became widely adopted and can now be universally used in all browsers. Let's jump right into the code. Here is our HTML file, which is our starting point, and its preview. We have here some heading and introductory paragraph, and then a section. In this section, we have two articles, one downloaded and one Google, which are styled as these cards. I have two cards because I want to show you two ways how you can import the web fonts. The first one is using downloaded fonts that you first need to find and download to your hosting and then just use in CSS. The second one will be using Google Fonts API, so I will show you both ways. Here are some styles. I'm importing the normalized CSS, so some basic things are reset on all browsers. And here's some styling. Let's start by using a downloaded font. I have one already imported. It's called Londrina Solid, and actually I got it from Google Fonts. Here, when you find something that you like, you can click download family and this downloads for you. So this is what I downloaded and unpacked in my project under the fonts directory. In order to import a font to your CSS, you need to use a font face at rule. Here is its description at MDN. The font face CSS at rule specifies a custom font with which to display text, so we can introduce any font that we like. The font face at rule takes a few descriptors, but the most important one is the font family, so that's the name of the font that we will be using in the rest of our rules. Then we have SRC. SRC points to a font, and here we can provide a list. So for example, we can start with local. So we want first to try a font that is on a user's computer. If the font is there, nothing will be downloaded. Only when this font doesn't exist on a user's computer, a URL will be fetched, and here we provide the name of the font. So that's the starting point. Let's go to the code and let's actually add our font face. So we are typing font face, and inside we first need to specify the font family. So font family, and that would be Londrina Solid. And then we need to provide the source. First, let's try locally. So local, Londrina, Solid. And only if that cannot be fetched, let's go with a URL. And I have it downloaded, so that's fonts. And then Londrina Solid directory, and let's go with a regular one. And actually, that's it already. So we can use this font right now. So let's do it. Here I have a placeholder for my styling of this section in here, first card with the downloaded font. So I'm going to style it. So I will remove this comment and style it. So my font family, I want to use Londrina Solid. And in case it cannot be downloaded, let's go with cursive and save. And I will refresh in here. And look, we have a font in here. So it's looking pretty well, it's looking pretty fancy. However, this font right now looks a little bit bold. So maybe regular is not what I'm looking for. Maybe I need to change this regular to a lightened version and refresh, it's looking a little bit better. But what if I wanted actually to have that bold as well? You can also notice I have a thin font in here and black. So in theory, I could be switching this option in here. So that would be black and save and refresh. And it's really, really bold, really black. Or I could go with thin and save and refresh. And it's really narrow, really light. Actually, there is an option to use the font face and specify different weights and styles. So actually, we can later use it with a basic CSS rule, for example, font weight, and specify 100 or 600 and so on. So let's try to do it now. I'm going to add here another descriptor that would be font style. So I want to style this for a normal, or instead of normal, I could specify italic and so on. But actually, this font works pretty well with all kinds. There isn't separate style for italic, so I'm not going to do that. Instead, I'm going to style the font weight. Let's start with the most thin one. That would be 100. And let's make sure which font is loaded. It is thin. Perfect. So now all I need to do is just copy and paste and paste and paste, because I have four fonts, and let's set the second one to be 300, and that would be light, and another one would be 400, and that would be regular, and this one I'm going to set it to bold, and let's make it 700. And the font is actually called not bold, but black. And save. Actually, we need to go a little bit lower. And here we can specify the font weight. So let's specify 100 and refresh. And look, it is really lightweight. But if I set it to 300 and save, it is a little bit bolder. If I set it to 700 and save, it is very, very bold. I'm good with 300, save and refresh, and it's quite okay. So now let's use Google Fonts API. Google Fonts API is an option which takes us a little bit further with the web fonts. We don't need to download the font and host it on our hosting. Instead, we can use the font that is hosted at Google. So let's try to do it now with this second box. I'm opening Google Fonts, that's fontsgoogle.com, and I can look here for various fonts with various styles and so on. Now it's only display and so on, but actually I will reset, and I have a font already which I like, and it is called Caveat. And here is this font, so I really like it. When we open it, we can, for example, provide here some text preview to test. This is a test text to preview. So it's looking quite okay. On the right side, you can see which font you like. On the right side, you can click a button to select this particular kind of font and then use it with Google Fonts API. So I will select regular 400, medium 500, semi-bold 600, and bold 700. And here, when I click View Selected Families, you can notice there's plenty of those fonts added. And here's instructions how to use that. So the first instruction is to embed some link into the HTML. But we are actually using CSS, which is a separate file. And more honestly, we are using a less file. So I'll scroll a little bit lower. And here's the actual part to import. So I will copy that and go to my code and style, and here I can just import this font. But that's not the end. I need also to scroll a little bit down, and here is the CSS rule to actually use my new font. So let's copy that and go back to code, and here we will provide the styling article Google, and here I can paste what I copied. So that's font family caveat and cursive. Save, and here I will refresh, And look, the font is added in here without any work on my side. I can now specify the font weight as well. Remember, we selected 400 up to 700. So let's try font weight 400 and refresh. Nothing changed because 400 is the default one, but let's make it 700 and refresh. And look, it's bolder now. All right. So what do you think? How Google does that? Though that is so simple. Let's check. I will scroll here and just copy this link that we got from Google and paste it in a browser. Look, all it does is simply provide a lot of font face attributes, the same kind of ones that we've used a few moments ago. So here we have a font family set to caveat. The font style is normal and the font weight is 400. The source is URL and here's the actual file to download. Finally, let's use caniuse.com to check if we can use font faces on all browsers. And the support is extremely huge, almost 99% of total browsers. So yes, it is widely adopted and widely supported now. I really hope you enjoyed this video and that you will be able to use this idea to make your site look more unique. If you enjoyed the video, make sure to subscribe. Please let me know in the comments down below what other ideas and challenges you would like to see here. Thanks for watching and see you in the next video. Bye-bye.